Hey, it's Randall Mithlow. How you doing? I'm just sitting here. I'm not really a morning person, so I'm really hitting the Java pretty hard here. Yeah, so I went into this place downtown, and I found some pretty good vinyl. This place used to sell just games and, game systems and things like that. Now they've expanded to music, and they've expanded into vinyl, cassettes, and I even saw some 8-tracks. They weren't worth getting, but it's a good sign. Maybe good things will come to that place. Anyway, the vinyl I got, all three of the pieces of vinyl I got from there, were very good, and they were in excellent condition, all three. They're all three by the same artist, Joni Mitchell. This is her first album, Song to a Seagull. This was a 1973 repress. I think this came out in 68 or 69, one of the two. Very folky, very quiet album, from what I've heard so far, which is the first side. Okay, and it is the gatefold, and there's a nice little picture of Joni herself. Awesome. Nice find in such good condition. So. Here we go. Next, we found Ladies of the Canyon. And as you can see, Joni has some of her artwork on here. Very nice. It is also, too, a gatefold with more lyrics than you probably want to see. And then, of course, the vinyl is in fantastic condition. Look at that. Whoa. You could eat off that, huh? Nice, right? You wouldn't want to eat off that. Anyway, so this got Big Yellow Taxi. Really haven't listened to this one yet, so the jury's still out. Okay. All right. So next, we have this one. Chord and Spark. Oops. Chord and Spark. And this too has a nice little picture of Joni in there, and again, lyrics. So, if you're into Joni lyrics, man, these are the three albums to get. So, anyway, like this, put on the first side of this, that song in here, Help Me. I didn't even know it was her. So, once again, album is in excellent condition. And again, a dollar for a classic like this, who could pass that up, right? Okay, speaking of classics, there is a thrift store I go into a lot, and all their vinyl is crap. It's all scratchy. It's all pre like 1965. It's all organ music. Terrible stuff. Show tunes, if you're into that. Well, you'd even have to get the scratchy versions of those show tunes. That's how bad their vinyl is most of the time. But then I ran across this one. It's the Moody Blues, and every good boy deserves favorite. Okay. And now I have this in cassette form too. When I came across this, I was like, I don't know. We'll give it a shot. We'll see what it looks like. So I'll pull it out. Vinyl is decent. It's a playable copy. And, I like the Moody Blues. And the funny thing is, I find Moody Blues everywhere around here. In fact, I could probably get their whole catalog around here on vinyl if I wanted to. It's like, didn't anybody want their Moody Blues stuff? I don't know. It's some of it does kind of sound dated a little bit, but I like it. This has a gatefold too, which my cassette does not, so this is kind of cool artwork. Very nice. Well, it's a little rough around the edges, but Rando will take it. Playable copy. Okay. Now, this one I actually bought off of Discogs because I will never find this out in the wild. And I'd never find this at a local record store. So I had to, throw a little money out there to get this. But it is Benoit Pouliard and Lasted. This is another one of his albums that I really like. Unfortunately, that's one of his worst covers, but one of my favorite songs by him is on here, and it's called RTO. And very nice album by Benoit Pouliard. Lasted. Okay, so that's that. Now, I did find a couple of CDs at that same place for $1 a piece. And they were almost worth showing, so I am going to show them. Okay, the first one is this one, and it is Amok by Atoms for Peace. And of course, this is Thom Yorke on vocals, guitar and stuff. And Flea's on here from Red Hot Chili Peppers, so it's quite interesting. And I love the gatefold of this one, too. This one's got, it appears to be Hollywood underwater and being attacked by comets. Okay. Now, unfortunately, that's where Rando was born, in that area. I was born in the LA area, and there's LAX right there. Right there. So, yeah, whatever, right? So, this is pretty good. This is IDM. Not Boards of Canada IDM, because they're singing in it. And, I believe it's pretty good. It's got a very meditative quality in some parts of it. Some parts of it's got a overriding beat that's pretty good. So, like this a lot. This is the first time I've actually heard this, so this is good. So, now, the other CD I found was one by another IDM artist, and it is, I don't know if you can see that, Autechre. And this is EP7. Sometimes on Autechre albums, the electronic beat kind of takes over the song, which is good or is bad. It's according if you like that beat. But anyway, not too bad. Autechre, EP7. I think it came out in 96 or 7. So, don't find this out in the wild very often, right? I don't find anything like this out in the wild. So it was a good find. All right, now to the cassettes. I know you've been waiting. Okay, so I'm going to start out with this one. This is Stephen Stills, Right By You. And this is a strange cover. It shows what looks like a rocket boat flying into outer space. That's interesting. But I'm going to do a little review of this. I listened to the first side of this. And while I find it very dated, as you can imagine, something from a 60s guy in the 1980s used to turn out, here you go. Well, the first song in here is called 50-50, and it has starts out being like a Caribbean feel to it. I don't know what's going on with that, but I do like the way he sings in that, so we'll give him that. All right. Next one is Stranger. Sounds like Sniffing the Tears to me. It sounds like a driver's seat, of all things. You may have been listening to that the day before you recorded this. Also, the next one is called Flaming Heart. And sounds kind of like a maybe Bonnie Raitt or, you know, George Thorogood maybe? I don't know. It's a good tune, though. I like a lot of good guitar on it. In fact, Jimmy Page from Led Zeppelin plays on this album quite a few tracks, and I'll bet he's playing on that one. The next song, Love Again, Jackson Browne, sounding new wave, kind of. Next one is No Problem. Kind of sounds like Robert Palmer, and maybe like singing in front of the Miami Vice theme or something. So, anyway, this is a bold release by Stephen Stills. Don't think it's going to become a classic anytime soon, but not bad. We'll give him a pass on that one, okay? All right. Just because he was with Crosby, Stills, and Nash. And Young. Okay. Speaking of them, here you go. Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young, American Dream. Okay? We all have one, right? Well, anyway. This came out in 1988, and there they are, much older looking than on the cover of Deja Vu. And there is the spine. Atlantic 40th anniversary. Pretty cool. Just a see-through cassette case, nothing special. And tell you what, the albums, it's kind of all over the place too. First four songs on here are kind of rough. American Dream, Got It Made, Name of Love's pretty good. Don't Say Goodbye. Oh, that is a rough song because of the dated keyboards. Then it starts to kick in around This Old House, Nighttime for the Generals, and then Shadowland is straight up new wave. Okay, so this is an interesting release by these guys. I don't think I can really knock it too much though, because a lot of the songs are by Neil Young, who I really dig. All right. Okay, then I got this boring Steve Miller Band album. Not a big fan of this guy, but Swing Town's a good song. I'll give that a good pass. But the rest of the stuff on here, not a big fan. So maybe I'll flip this or give it away. If anybody out there likes Steve Miller, wants a nice cassette. Okay. Then I got a couple of cassette singles here. I got Metallica, Nothing Else Matters. Pretty good condition. I've never seen a Metallica cassette single, so that's interesting. Oh, cassette singles seem to be black too. And there you go. And it's got Inner Sandman live on the backside, somewhere in Russia. And of course, there's a picture of them. Used to be a big Metallica fan, the first three or four albums, but I don't know. Don't do much for me anymore. Oh well. Okay, then I got this one from Queen. This is The Show Must Go On. And look what the B-side is. Bohemian Rhapsody. Yeah. Awesome. Classic. Great. Love it. Cool artwork on there too. I turn it over and it says on here that it is for AIDS research or something like that. So all the proceeds from this cassette single went to that. So pretty nice condition. Again, black. Awesome. Okay. Then we got White Snake. And this is Slip of the Tongue. This wasn't as big a hit, I guess, as the White Snake 1987 album with Here I Go Again. That song on there. But this is pretty good. I like this one. I would have to give that probably a 6 of 10, maybe. I don't know. It's a good rocking album. Not bad. All right. And I found, forgot this cassette single. This is Poison and Something to Believe In. And this is off of Open Up and Say Ah. And there's the Enigma logo on there. Nice picture of the band there. Looking all crazy. Jamming down. Hey, pretty nice font there. I like that. And someone got a tattoo of it, apparently. Good song. Here's another one. May Get Flipped. It's Eels on the Border. Not sure why I picked this up, but it's one of the reissues from the late 80s of this, I think. Well, maybe not. It has this on here, which indicates early 80s when they used to stack them up. And this would be how they would pull them out of the case and store them this way. Okay. There you go, Eagles on the Border. Best of My Love is on here. Not my favorite song. But the other songs in there are kind of decent. I wouldn't have thought it would be listenable, but it is. So I guess these early Eagle albums are a little bit better. I don't know. Take it or leave it, I guess. Okay. Then I got a huge hit from the 1980s. It is Def Leppard, Hysteria. This is probably my third copy I've got of this, but none of them played. This one actually played through. Very nice. Always like when they play all the way through and I don't have to toss them and just keep the J cards. Anyway, there you go. And it's a clear cassette, chock full of hits. Pour Some Sugar on Me, Rocket, Love Bite. And of course, the great song Hysteria, which, very cool song. And that's that. Towers. And this is Towers. Very ambient, very nice, like it. And as you can see on the OBI strip there, it has a marking that says slash of 50. So unfortunately they didn't put a number there, so I don't know which copy I got, but there's only 50 of these. Geometric Lullaby is so hard to get any of the releases because they're always gone. All 50 of them are always gone in like an hour. Okay. So you got a very small window to get these. All right. And then this is awesome. It is Birds and it is Younger Than Yesterday. Great album by the Birds. Probably, I want to say their third or fourth album. 1967. There were four of them then instead of five. Can't remember who left. Gene left. Okay. So, excellent, excellent album. It's got some psychedelic stuff in it. It's got some experimental stuff in it. Backwards guitaring. Guitaring? It has backwards guitar solos. So, excellent album. Glad to have it in my collection. Thank you so much. 29 cents. Yes. Okay. And the last cassette I have is this Bob and Tom's Greatest Hits. Bob and Tom, of course, being the DJ morning host, that station out of Indianapolis. Listen to them about every morning for years and years. They're some of their greatest hits. Their parody songs, their skits and stuff. Very good. And this is a slipcover. And, well, I'm going to have to pull them out for you. So you can see, but they have their own J cards. And there's the cassettes. And that's one. Now the other one has this cover where they're playing Rock'em Sock'em Robots. And it looks like Tom is losing. Okay. Some good classic comedy here. Like it. And that is all of my cassettes. Oh, I can't forget this one. Richard and Linda Thompson, and this is Shoot Out the Lights. A very good album. It's kind of hard to describe. It's kind of poppy, but it's, Richard Thompson plays some great guitar on this album. Even when it slows down with Linda's ballads that she has on here, he puts a ragged guitar solo in it that sounds so good. This is probably one of their best albums. I think they were going through marital problems at the time, so apparently that made it great. But anyway, love it. Shoot Out the Lights. Don't Renege on Their Love. Some excellent tunes on here. And this is, as you can see, it is High Performance Pro Chrome Tape. Awesome. Hannibal Records. And there it is. Awesome. Okay.
Alrighty then. I guess that's all I have for you today. But, you know, when Randall wakes up a little bit more, maybe he'll go out looking today and get another batch. So, until next time, keep rocking.